Hello everyone, today I am visiting an organic farm and the farm's name is Brindavan. On the right is the crop of pearl millet. In this farm, no chemical fertilizers or pesticides are used. This is a unique farm because there are different sections which have been named after the places in Vrindavan. One of the sections is Barsana. Nangav is another section where they keep their cows. The cows here are indigenous A2 cows, which have a hump on their back. A2 milk is easy to digest and it is healthier than A1 milk. This is the cow shed where they make the cows rest and feed. Mansi Ganga is another section where organic fertilizers are made and kept. This is the fertilizer. It is made by layering dry waste and wet waste from the plants alternatively and then coating the topmost area with cow dung. The liquid in the barrel is called liquid manure. It is made by mixing the fertilizer with water. They conserve the soil quality with a technique called mulching. Mulching is a process in which dried products of plant are layered on the soil. It prevents the soil from getting extreme heat. It also helps the soil in retaining moisture. All the plants in this farm are grown with the organic fertilizers and are maintained by the process of mulching. This is cluster beans plant. This is the plant of ladyfinger and its flowers. In this farm, the seeds are not given the time to disperse from the flowers but are preserved, and when the crop is harvested, they sow the seeds again. This whole patch is of bottle gourd. You can see this ready to use bottle gourd. This is the plant of watermelon, which is a creeper. So once a watermelon is fully grown, it reproduces another watermelon. So you can see many watermelons over here. Look at this mango tree. It is merely 2 years old and still it bears mangoes. This is a papaya tree and it is having raw papayas. There are plenty of such trees in this farm. In addition to fruits and vegetables, they also grow cotton, castor and fenugreek seeds. This is cotton's flower. This is its bud. And these are the ready cotton. These are castor's leaves. And these are dried fenugreek seeds. This was an amazing experience on an organic farm. After getting knowledge about organic farming, I think everyone should prefer organic farming to modern farming.